Hey, Vinyl Community, it's VK here back in the VK Lounge and the Zepper channel. I wanted to do a response to David Sequoia Flame, who just hit 1,000 subs. Wow, man, that's David, love you. I love some of the things you show. I try to comment as much as I can, but usually, you know, you're showing stuff that I have no idea, and I don't want to sound like an idiot, but man, I'm always learning something from you. You're entertaining, you make me laugh, you know, so it's very cool. I enjoy seeing you on the Facebook page as well, and I know we're connected too, so I appreciate that. Right now, of course, you know, for anybody that doesn't know, man, I have schematics for a Blank Stare, Acid Rain playing in the background. This is something that David had a big hand in promoting and putting together and stuff like that, and even our own Nathan Morales had something to do with the artwork, I believe. Helped him out a little too. So we got that going on. So definitely, if you haven't, checked that out, definitely do. We'll stay up there. All right, David hit 1,000 subs, man. Congrats! You know that's awesome, man. You know I've only been in the VC a little over a year now. And, you know, it's growing, but I know you've been in here for a while. You show some killer stuff, so you deserve everything. And I'm sure everybody loves enjoys your channel. David asked us a three-part question, at least that's the way I took it. So I'm going to kind of go ahead and try to hit this with my best shot. No pun intended to Pat Benatar. That was weak. All right. First of all, let's see. Well, let's do the easy one. The easy one for me was, you know, David asked, you know, everybody kind of, he's kind of has his little trademark laugh, you know, he has this freaking hysterical laugh, you know. And you know it's genuine too, man, because it comes from the gut and he just laughs and it's great. So David asked us to show a record or do a sound clip or whatever that has a laugh in it. Well, if anybody out there knows anything about me, you know what I'm going to do, so I chose Led Zeppelin off of Physical Graffiti at the end of the song Bronwyar Stomp. There's Robert Plant laughs, and here's the needle drop. Check it out. And we're back! Alright, so there was Bronwyar stopped a little laugh at the end there. A little needle drop from Physical Graffiti. Alright, the next question he had on the list there wanted to, I don't know how to answer this, man. It was kind of weird, but alright, I'll jump in the fire with this. Said if there was an album, you know, music and look wise or something that you could have, that you could change and go back and physically put it into a person, I guess, and have sex with it. Well, I really didn't know how to do this one, but I kind of, you know, the first thing that kind of came to mind was this, man. This cover for her, you know, we all know this cover. It's pretty well known. And how could you not want to, you know, get a little whipped cream on yourself? You know, and, you know, you got Herb Albert's little trumpet, sexy sounds, I guess you want to say. And, you know, and how can you resist that, man? How could you not want to get a little whipped cream? So there you go. Why not? That's, I only did one because, I don't know. I don't know. I'm sure I could have pulled out some hot heavy metal chick or something, or Lita Ford maybe. But, I don't know. That's kind of where I was going with it. And the last thing was you had the debate of old vinyl versus new. And I'm more towards the old vinyl, I guess. You know, you get a lot of these, you know, I mean, if an album now just comes out, let's say, for example, I got the Jimmy Page Black Crowes. I don't know, I guess it was a reissue, but I never had the original either. I don't know, maybe that's a bad example. But let's say, you know, I want to find an original first pressing kind of thing, let's say of Miles Davis' Bitches Brew. I don't have that album. Yeah, sure, I can go get a reissue that's out today, and it'll sound nice and clean, but I just kind of do like that old vinyl. I want to have that artifact of when it came out, that first copy. or close to, So I like to find those. In fact, sometimes I won't get the reissue just because I want to find that, even though sometimes, like certain albums, like King Crimson, all right, there's a perfect example. The first album, In the Court of the Crimson King. That would be a perfect example because, all the copies I find, even mine, there's pops and cracks in it, but I'd like to have the original, even though the reissue, it'd be nice and clean, probably thick 180 gram vinyl. That might be an album that I do that with, but I do prefer the older vinyl, and like to have the original stuff, man. I want the original inner sleeves and posters or stickers and things that came with it, fold outs and gatefolds and all of that, So I do like to find the old copies. Not knocking the new stuff because obviously, as long as they're putting it out, there's bands putting out their new albums, a new Deep Purple album or something like that, the new Pearl Jam record. That's the way it's going to come out. And that's actually, 20 years from now, that's going to be the original first press. So that's cool, the reissues, I tend to stay away a little. Not to say that I haven't gotten some. I did get a Live Evil, I think, from Miles Davis just because it was a good deal. And, I haven't been able to find any Miles Davis or John Coltrane or anything like that, really, out in the wild. And if it is, it's usually $40, $50. And then why don't, might as well, if I'm going to pay that much, I might as well go get the reissue. So at least it's going to play well. But there you go. I'm rambling on here. So there you go, David. I did a little needle drop for Led Zeppelin on the Laughter track that you need. And what album cover would I want to, get busy with? Well, you can't do wrong with a little whipped cream and other delights. And old vinyl, man, all the way. All right, buddy, congratulations. Thanks for stopping by. I hope that, you double that in the next year, I'm sure. And keep the VC alive, man. Cheers. Rock on.